Hello and welcome to Study with Sudhir, your digital classroom. A lot of confusion taking place among students as far as the English literature paper is concerned. Can we attempt three questions from one section? That is three questions from either Merchant of Venice or from poems or from stories. That is the query raised by a lot of students. Teachers also not very clear about the rule. So let me make this video just to clarify the position. Now, why did the confusion essentially arise? Now, last year was the first year 2019 paper when Treasure Trove was introduced into the syllabus. And the instructions given on top of the question paper, the 2019 question paper, if you see, says attempt 5 questions in all from only 3 textbooks. Now, why the 3 textbooks have been mentioned in particular? That's because there are lots of textbooks from which different schools follow. For instance, some schools follow The Merchant of Venice by Shakespeare, some schools follow The Mousetrap as the instead of Merchant of Venice by Agatha Christie. Then in the story section, there are these options of, apart from Treasure Trove, there is also Animal Farm or The Call of the Wild. So there are these different options, which is why the board made it clear that attempt 5 questions in all only from 3 textbooks. Now, the second part of this instruction was what was causing all the confusion. It said you must attempt at least 1 question from each of section A, which is the drama, The Merchant of Venice or Agatha Christie, section B, which is the poetry section, and section C, which is the Treasure Trove stories or Animal Farm or the other one. And this part, the operative part, was what was causing the confusion. And not more than 2 other questions from the same books you have already compulsory chosen. Now, whoever drafted this instruction, especially for an English literature paper, well, did a huge amount of disservice, because he or she only ended up creating a whole lot of confusion. Because the moment you read it, you will think that you cannot attempt more than 2 questions from the same section. But then read it carefully, and that's what the board failed to do. Reread its own instructions to see whether it was being clear to a third person. It says you must attempt at least 1 question from section A, section B, section C. Fine, you cannot do only stories and poems and leave out William Shakespeare altogether, or do MOV and poems and leave out stories altogether. You can't do that. You need to do 1 each. Fine, no problem, no confusion on that. It says, and not more than 2 other questions from the same books. It is referring to the same books. That is, just in case someone decides to do Merchant of Venice 1 question and 1 question from Agatha Christie, that will be disqualified, that will not be allowed. Or someone does Treasure Trove and also does 1 question from Animal Farm, that will be disallowed. So that is what was causing all the confusion, which is why if you look at the ICSE website specimen paper for 2020 of English literature, they have actually corrected themselves, because now the instruction is much more clear. It says you must attempt 1 question from each of the sections, that is A, B and C, fine, and any 2 other questions. So they have made it very clear that now you can attempt any other 2 questions. There is no limit on whether you can or cannot attempt how many questions from each section. So you are free to attempt, say, 3 poetry questions and 1 from MOV, Merchant of Venice, and 1 from the story section, or 3 from stories and 1 from MOV and poetry, or 3 from MOV, 1 from poetry, 1 from section. So let this be very, very clear that there is no problem in having a 3 plus 1 plus 1 kind of an arrangement instead of the classical 2 plus 2 plus 1 arrangement. Sounds a bit like hockey. Okay, now I will tell you whether 3 plus 1 plus 1 is really the best thing to do or not, and this is my opinion. In my opinion, I think 2 plus 2 plus 1 is still better, and I will tell you why. If you are attempting 3 of Merchant of Venice, now the problem with the play is that there is only one basic plot, right? And all the questions of all the 3 extracts that you will be given from the Shakespearean play will essentially somehow or the other directly or indirectly connect to the main plot, right? Which will be either be the caskets or the trial scene where the Shylock tries to take revenge on Antonio. Now, there is the risk of actually sounding a bit repetitive if you actually attempt all the 3 extracts. And that is a risk I wouldn't want students to take, of sounding repetitive, because by the time the examiner comes to the third answer, he may feel the student is only basically repeating the point. So, which is why I think there is a risk in attempting 3 questions from Merchant of Venice. That is my advice, entirely up to you. In the stories section, what one has seen is that they give a question which carries 8 marks. That is, instead of the 4 plus 4 plus 4 plus 4, 16 marks, or 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 4, 16 marks. In one of the questions from the stories, like last year they gave it from All Summer in a Day, they gave a 4 plus 4 plus 8 combination. Now the problem with this 8 mark question is, like for instance last time it was, describe how the planet was transformed when the sun came out and shone briefly over it, that is Venus planet. Why was Margaret not able to witness this phenomenon? What emotion do you suppose the other children experienced when Margaret emerged at the end of the story? The questions are not tough, but the problem with the 8 mark question is that immediately you get a little daunted by how much of detail you need to give. In fact, this is still better that they actually gave 3 questions. So you can actually mentally break it up saying that, okay, one will be 4, the other will be 2 each probably. Sometimes they give, for instance, especially in stories like the Blue Bead, and I've seen it in a few pre-board papers, Blue Bead, describe the fight between Sibia and the crocodile. You know, and how the Gujar woman was rescued by Sibia. Now, the problem is that when you write so much in an 8-mark question, there is always the risk of leaving out some keyword or some detail in the story because of which you could actually lose mark. Which is why my advice all along through all the videos that we have done on English literature as well as in the comment section, I always say avoid the 8-mark question. So, stories also, if you get an 8-mark question, you obviously, I would advise you not to attempt the third one, the especially the one which has come with a 8-mark question. So, poetry, you could go in for 3 plus 1 Merchant of Venice and 1 from stories, or you could go for the classical 2 plus 2 plus 1. Also, 2 plus 2 plus 1 gives the examiner a sense that, okay, this student seems to have kind of concentrated on all parts of the syllabus instead of just concentrating on, say, just the poetry or just Merchant of Venice or just the stories. The other point is that what the board is obviously, at least by the instruction last year was given, was trying to make it very clear that do not attempt more than 5 questions. Do not attempt an extra question. This is another query which is often asked, whether you should do an extra question. Now, let me deal with it, especially with connection with the English literature paper. English literature paper, 5 questions in 2 hours, 120 minutes. That means, without leaving any time for revision, you have approximately just about 24 minutes to write each 16 mark answer. Trust me, you will not even have time to revise your paper because there will be so much to write in the sense that you need to frame your sentences. All that takes time, right? Even though the answers need not be necessarily very long. So you need to kind of spend time. You will need that much time. 20 to 24 odd minutes. Ideally, you should target yourself to finish 20 to 22 minutes so that you can leave some time at the end to revise your answers quickly. You wouldn't have the time to attempt an extra question. So you should focus all your energies to doing these 5 answers well. Write them well without any spelling mistakes, without any grammatical mistakes, because there will be absolutely no time, trust me, to write an extra answer. So that is as far as this entire confusion. I thought I'll do this video just to clarify what the position is, that you can do a 3 plus 1 plus 1 combination, but also I pointed out the risk involved or the perils, let me say, of attempting all 3 from Merchant of Venice or all 3 from stories. Also, the stories and the poems, when you attempt from there, it will give you a wide variety. Each answer will actually sound a little obviously different from the other because they are not dealing with the same plot, which would be the case as far as the Shakespearean play would be concerned. So I hope this makes it very clear. I hope there will be any more doubts as far as this is concerned. Any comments to make, write in the comment section. Like, share and subscribe to Study with Sudhir. Thank you very much for watching.